will they all land here on the lake? Now the sun is asking, are they going to come and land on the lake? Let's see what's the other thing. They look too high. I think they are aiming for somewhere else. So now the son tells the father, are they really going to come and land here? Because they are too high. And I think they are going to move to some other place. I don't think that they are going to come and land here. Who decides? They know. So now the son is asking, who decides? So father is telling, they know. Then they were overhead, the sky filled with masses of birds in flight, a flurry of bird calls. Father and son looked at each other. Now they started moving and the sky was filled with more number of birds and a flurry of bird calls. What do you understand by flurry? Yes, all the birds call together. They start chirping at once. That is called as flurry. So here the father is telling, the writer is telling that they started moving and the sky was filled with many birds and the birds were also chirping all together, not one by one, at once. Father and son looked at each other. When they heard this birds chirping, the son and father looked at each other. Here goes. The man undid his safety catch and started firing. So here the father's telling, see, here goes. The birds have come. So father took his gun and started firing, throwing buckshot at the sky. The explosions shook the boat. The lake rippled. He pumped the gun empty. Too high. They are flying much too high. So here, what happened? He started firing at the birds. And the firing of the bird was so strong that because of that firing, there were small waves in the water. You know, when there is a bomb blast, you can feel that earth shake, right? A kind of earthquake is heard. Right? So here, the writer is also telling, when they started firing, there was rippling in the water. And moreover, they fired in such a way that the loaded guns became empty. And moreover, he's also telling that they are too high. They are flying too much high. And lastly, he's telling, he pumped the gun empty. This means the loaded gun is empty now. There are no bullets in it. See what happens here. His son slowly raised his rifle. He had a more patient and steady hand. The father is not as patient as his son, because according to his father, the father says birds are too fast. They move as the clouds are moving. And the son was patient enough, and when he saw his father aiming at the bird and missed the aim, the son silently takes the gun in his hand. And see what he does. He picked a single speck out of the mass in the sky, the leader of the formation flying towards them. He aimed and fired. The speck plummeted. So now the son was so curious and so aiming at only one bird. The father aimed at many birds. The son just aimed at one bird. And who was that bird? That bird was leader of the mass of birds. So he aimed at that bird. He took his gun and aimed that bird, and the bullet was reached the bird, and the bird fell in the water. See now how he was happy. And he enjoyed what he was doing. But there he got a feeling of, why did I hurt a bird? Let's see what he does now. You got the leader, the man cheered. The father is happy because the son has shot the leader of the bird. Another bird swiftly took its place. They were all leaders by instinct. The moment the leader of the bird fell in, the other bird from the mass took up the initiative to lead the other birds. I want to find it. The boy put down his rifle and took the paddle. Did you see where? So now the boy is worried. Where has it fallen? So he asked my father, I want to find it, Dad. And he just dropped his gun down and he's telling, Dad, did you see where has it fallen? So let's see what happens now. It just fell behind the bulrushes. Go around that way. So now the father is telling, yes, I saw it fell near the small trees and plants which is at the side of a lake. So they are going towards the bird now. The boy moved the boat against the tide of teal still reeling overhead. His arms trembled as he pulled the paddle through the black water. So now the boy was so caring about the bird that he started rowing his boat so quickly that he ensured he reached the bird. I think I can see it, he said, leaning forward. So now the boy will lean a little forward, move a little bit forward and tell, Dad, I can see that. There was a lump floating on the water, a broken wing, pointing at the sky like the ragged sail of a toy boat. See, when you usually make paper boats, there is another kind of boat which we make, right? We tell it has its leg. And when if it is a yacht, that it is the opposite of water scene. Am I right? So here the boat fell in the bulrushes, that is the trees and plants near a side, and it started floating on the water. So this boy told that it's looking like a ragged sail of a toy boat. It's looking like a toy boat which is floating in the water. The boy lifted the paddle and they glided up to it. So the boy finally goes towards the floating wild duck. He bent over the side and scooped it up. From the boat only, he'll bend on to one side and scooped it up. In the sand, he takes out the duck from water. Well done, the man said. And now the father is appreciating the son, telling, well done, my child. Now the son is very silent. His son was silent. The duck was big and helpless. Touching its soft feathers and its thin bony neck, the boy looked frightened at what he had done. So now the duck has a very thin neck and it has very soft feathers. The boy is worried. What has happened to the duck? He's looking very frightened. He looks like something, he's done something wrong. Then the duck lifted up its head. When the boy shot at the duck, he thought that it's died. So he was worried, I think I've done wrong, I shouldn't have done it. But the moment the duck was lifting up its head, he was happy. It's not dead. Look, it's not dead, he's telling his father. Dad, the duck is alive. The blood seemed to flow again in the boy's arms. He breathed in relief. The duck looked blank. Now, obviously, when you fire at anybody, you see that the blood starts flowing immediately, right? So here, when the bird was also shot, it was aimed at the wings, and the wings were bleeding. So when the boy took out the bird from the water and he keeps it in his arms, he finds that his arms are filled with the bird's blood. So let's see what he does now.